The magic of horrible histories is it appeals to everyone, and it's kind of, regardless of your age or where you're from or anything, it appeals to that part of you that just loves a poo joke. And I do a fair few, and probably in this episode for the BBC, probably in other episodes. It's all just a big merging of poo. But anyway, it's just a glorious, silly, fun, wonderful show that everyone can watch as a family. And that's really special, I think, at the moment.
In terms of the smorgasbord of characters you breathe life into, do you have personal favourites?
This is an interesting question, because people say, what's your favourite character? I'm like, I have done hundreds and I can't remember any of them. It's just this big kind of carousel of characters, you know, because we film about, I'd say I do two a day or something. So it's like in the makeup chair, what's my accent? What are my lines? And then you're just thrust into it. But there's just some beautiful characters from all parts of history, whether it be, you know, I've been a caveman all the way up to modern times. And it's just joyful. That's why I love being in the show, because you never know what you're going to get next.
I mean, the show's a lot of fun, but on a serious note, why do you think it is so important for us to continue to examine and explore our history, and perhaps not just the sanitized view that we sometimes have of that?
I think humor is such a brilliant way of breaking down walls and really seeing something in a different light. I think having a sense of humor is such a wonderful and important skill that we should cherish, because actually it just helps lighten that kind of negative energy and be able to see something a bit more objectively. So we can laugh at it, we can see, okay, that was bad, that was an awful time, but also look how we've moved on, or look how ridiculous we were then and how life can kind of get us down in this way. And actually humor is such a great way of just reflecting and looking at something in a different way.
In terms of the BBC special, what does it mean for you to be part of celebrating an astonishing legacy of storytelling and entertainment programming like that?
I mean, most of my work comes from the BBC. I love the BBC. I am so proud of the BBC, and there is not enough pride in the BBC. Things like the BBC, the NHS, they're the greatest institutions in the world, and I believe that we should be more proud of them. And we're not very good as Britain at being proud of things, and I think this is an opportunity, this episode, to reflect and say, hey, this is an amazing institution that we should cherish rather than continually scrutinize.
What makes the show so special, and how do you feel to be celebrating it here at this festival specifically?
Well, the show is a massive team effort, and that is what makes it as brilliant as it is, because there's so many different creative forces at work. So there's amazing researchers getting all the facts, and then there's a brilliant writing team, and the cast and the design and the costume and the makeup and the whole production all coming together is a big team effort. So it's nice to be able to celebrate that here.
Of the smorgasbord of amazing characters, historical figures that you've had the chance to breathe life into, do you have personal favourites? And when you meet people, do they have ones that they're most excited to talk to you about?
I love playing Queen Victoria, because it's quite nice to get cross and shout at people. But I don't love the fact that it takes 3 hours of prosthetics to get to look like her. And people are always interested in that. I also like playing the ones that wear comfy costumes, really. That's a kind of, not wearing a corset is always a gift.
And of the periods of time that you guys have explored, is there one that when you were younger you were most fascinated by, or you've grown to be the most interested in as you've learnt about it with the show?
I'm quite into the 20s at the moment, because we're doing some research and writing an episode about it. So that seems like a kind of nice time of wild abandon and lots of parties and things between the wars. But yeah, I feel like the joy of the show is there's always more to learn about, and there are always periods that you perhaps didn't know as much about before, but the more you hear, you're like, I need to know more about this.
Why do you think it is so important for us to continually explore and re-examine our history, and not just a sanitized view of it, but the reality that this show particularly delves into?
Because we can draw parallels now. There's so many things where we go, oh, that sounds a bit weird, but then you kind of think about there are current relevant examples with like healthcare and with education and stuff. And also we can learn from it. We can learn from other people's mistakes and other people's good ideas and go, well, they had it right before we had phones and before we had, you know, all of this extra information. So it's just endlessly fascinating.
In terms of the other cast members, who do you find the hardest to keep a straight face around?
Oh, I mean, all of them, to be honest. It's basically once those giggles are let into the room, it's kind of hard to stop. So I think if there's ever a day where one of us goes, everybody loses it, and then we have to try and be disciplined because we have so much to shoot in such a small amount of time. So we have to try and rein it in as much as we can, but it's very infectious.
And you mentioned you've got the 20s coming up. Is there anything else, you know, with the show coming up that we should be also excited about?
Oh, we've got, this BBC special will be, I mean, it's such a long time since we shot it, so I'm really excited to see it. And we shot it in lockdown, so it's going to be very different to a typical Horrible History show, because we had to be distant and all of that stuff. But there's plenty happening in the next series, which is going to shoot later this year.